the Deer Park Lanes, the new $5.5 million Brunswick Recreation Center, Lake Zurich, Illinois, hosts the 20th anniversary of the Brunswick Memorial World Open. In 1971, it all started with Don Johnson getting the victory. He would win again in 72. Johnson, the Hall of Famer, built a great tradition for this tournament. And last year, his son Jimmy opened the championship match with six strikes to defeat number one seed Robert Lawrence, 243 to 227 in his rookie year on tour. 20 international stars have been invited here from all over the world. A field of 240 started play earlier this week. Here are the five who have made it to the stepladder finals. It's all coming up on NBC Sports. Memorial World Open, a very special event on the fall tour. Hello, everybody. Jay Randolph, happy to have you with us this afternoon. We have got five very talented people in the stepladder finals. Ron Palombi Jr. on top, Jess Stayrook, then Del Ballard Jr., Harry Sullins, and David Ozio. And all in all, we can expect great action today. And joining me, of course, Hall of Famer Earl Anthony. Earl, great veterans here, but you know, we haven't had a 300 game all week.
And I don't expect one today either, Jay, and it's because of the lane condition. The PBA's philosophy is to do the lanes very difficult for major tournaments such as this one, and it makes the shot makers come to the top. All 24 of the finalists were great shot makers. These five that survived that field are the best. David Ozio in a running for Bowler of Europe, he should win today. In my opinion, he would lock up that title.
Well, we'll see what happens. It's going to be a very exciting tournament here. And there's $33,000 in prize money to the winner. And as well as that, the Bayliner 1700 Capri Bowrider, the wonderful boat package from Brunswick. And also for a 300 game today, well, a Corvette, the 92 ZR1, powered by a Mercury Marine Division motor from Brunswick that is really a dandy. Let's get to our first match as David Ozio goes against Harry Sullins.
Ozio qualifying fifth with a 210.95 average out of Vidor, Texas, the right-hander, 37 years old. He lost to Sullins in round one of match play, 279 to 266. He was in the lead here for most of the week. Opening on lane 23 in fine fashion.
When we talked about shot makers at the beginning, Jay, this is the premier, I think, right now on the tour, David Ozio. The supreme stylist, perfect condition as far as position at the foul line, gets through the ball very well, stays down, and a good result, obviously.
Harry Sullins, the man they call the legend, and that 10 pin over there in the corner.
Harry scoring Detroit. Scoring this week, Jay, as we talked about also, is has not been very high. The leader's averaging 208, 9, 10 in that area. Harry Sullins does what you have to do on a difficult condition. He throws it extremely hard. He'll throw the ball up over 20 miles an hour. A normal speed for most pro bowlers in that 16 to 17 mile an hour range.
Both these players had high games of 279 this week. Sullins, 34 years old, a 9-year veteran of the PBA Tour. Harry's won better than $365,000 in his career on tour. Has three national titles. Ozio has nine. Short.
Got a break. Got a big break.
That's the four pin.
He kind of lost it at the foul line there, Jay. He got a little fast with his feet. He was off balance. The ball just went out to the right. Never really had his normal, very, very strong rotation on it. Just flew off his hand. Easy spare here. You go cross lane at the four pin. Harry Sullins has always been good on difficult lane conditions. Again, because of his ball speed. He's extremely hard, as I mentioned, and he can do that all day long.
Ozio on the television pair averaged 188.5 in two games. His sixth telecast of 1991. And Ozio leaves the four. 13 years on the tour. And as you mentioned, Ozio, a very talented performer. All of these fellas have been around long enough to be able to adapt.
They have. They're all very experienced players. Again, ball speed is the key. If you make a mistake here in ball speed, you pay the supreme penalty. It's either going to be the bucket or the washout. If you're a little bit too hard with the ball, if you're a little soft or a little slow with it, you're going to get the 4-6 or the big four or something of that nature. You're not going to get the good breaks. And that's why one of the reasons the scoring has been what it has been. It's a very flat surface. The lane condition is oiled 38 feet. Double oil in the heads in the first 15 feet of the lane. Makes the ball skate very, very quickly, and then you have to line it to the pocket to keep it in play.
Six pin for Ozio. This fivesome, you total up their years on the tour, 48 years of experience here. Big crowd on hand in this marvelous new facility, this ultra-modern Brunswick Recreation Center here. Lake Zurich, Illinois. It's the second stop on the fall tour. Next week we'll be in Rochester, and then we'll finish up in Detroit the following week. A strike for Sullins over on 24.
And here's a good look at the style of Harry Sullins. Watch how he'll plant his foot at the foul line. You'll see the good free arm swing from the shoulder. Lets the ball swing back of its own volition. He doesn't use a lot of muscle. But at the foul line, he plants the foot. He's way ahead of the ball. That's where he gets the strength, using his legs to pull the ball through, get that ball speed that he feels he needs to score well in this lane condition.
Even Steven here in the early going between Ozio and Sullins. And it went down, that seven pin, a little late. Sullins is up by 10. We'll be back with more right after this.
NBC Sports coverage of the PBA Fall Tour is brought to you by Brunswick. Bowling is sold on Brunswick. By Toyota and their quality line of 1992 cars and trucks. Toyota, I love what you do for me. By the Olympics Triple Cast, a whole new way to see the games. And by Old Spice Deodorant, because prevention is the ultimate form of protection. Count on it.
Target.
The Brunswick Phantom. Bowling's first ball with a built-in guidance system, programmable to your game. Phantom's stealth core system works like onboard intelligence to give you unbelievable consistency and reaction predictability every time you strike. Get a Phantom. It's the guidance system for your game.
Hey, Chi-Chi, won't you take us for a ride?
Okay, if your brother's not the same.
The Toyota Previa. It's roomy, comfy, and built for safety, so Chi-Chi loves taking his kids for a drive.
We love what you do for us. Hey,
that was then. This is now. Odor prevention then.
odor prevention now. Introducing the pump deodorant from Old Spice. It beats the leading aerosol deodorant, actually prevents odor better with a superior formula that's right on target, unlike that messy cloud. Pump up your odor prevention with the Old Spice pump.
The Broncos. The Chiefs. An AFC West showdown for first Sunday.
Joe Antonora on the right, commissioner of the PBA Tour. He'll be leaving the tour in January, and the new commissioner-elect, Mike Connor from Akron, Ohio. And we'll be visiting with Mike Connor a little later on. For Ozio, spares in the fourth and fifth. Sullins, a strike in the fifth. A three-bagger for him, and the lead of 23. About adapting, and Sullins seems to be going good and adapting. Now there's some problem apparently, Earl, at the foul line over there on lane 23.
Well, that's nothing major. There's just something on the lane itself, and they're gonna Ozio doing the right thing, put
it's
the ball
a
down. And Larry Lichtenstein, the Players Services Director, is gonna go out and remove the
Larry
buck
can do it all.
He can do it all.
Okay. Way to go, Larry. Jack of all trades.
Well, Harry Sullins with a four-bagger, a big break in the second frame when he broke down that difficult spare, ended up only with the four-pin. Then he comes back with a high, hard one in the fourth frame for the double, and then he gets the big break on the crossover in the sixth. So a little variety there, but very, very important at this point. David Ozio will get going. He has to start now.
Yes, Ozio deep in the hole, and a little late 7-10 action.
He's playing that really extreme angle, right on the very edge of the lane, where if you make any mistake at all to the right, it's going in the channel. You get zero. Ozio being the great shot maker we've mentioned, here's a good look at his game. Watch the swing straight back and through from behind. Watch how close he is to the channel. Right on the edge of the lane. Look how well he stays down with the shot. Shoulders over the knee. Perfect position. All right, here's another angle. Good look at how close he is to the edge of the lane. Look at the ball. It's actually hanging over the channel at that point. Takes courage to play that angle, Jay.
It sure does. Comes battling back. A strike in the seventh. He's down 23. Back with more from Lake Zurich, Illinois.
Most guys kick back on the weekend. Jack, on the other hand,
taste as genuine as the people who drink it. Budweiser.
Tomorrow,
we're sleeping in.
This season, give the Olympics triple cast of the 92 Summer Games. Call 1-800-OLYMPIC, order the gold package, and get a set of Olympic pins, a commemorative book, the 92 highlights tape, and 2 solid weeks of all the best events. Order now and get a free Olympic warm-up jacket. Give the Olympics triple cast. Catch the fire behind the flame.
Fresh roasted whole kernel corn.
And you know what? They've got a lot less fat than the leading corn chips. Look, you can even see the difference.
More and less Pringles Corn Crisps. More corn for your taste, less fat for your waste. Pringles Corn Crisps.
More corn, less fat.
A week ago last last Thursday at the Palmer House in downtown Chicago. Brunswick honoring Eddie Elias, the founder of the PBA, and Milt Rudeau, the former Brunswick executive, who was the first president of the Hall of Fame and Museum down in St. Louis. It was a wonderful, wonderful evening. I was thrilled to be there. Well, we are in the eighth. We're through it. Ozio open in the eighth. He is in real trouble. Needs a strike here on 23 and gets it. Oh, that's a big, big strike.
And while we were away, we're going to take another look at David Ozio's shot. Again, him playing what the players call the twig, that being the very edge of the lane, getting the all-important strike in the ninth frame here to load up for the 10th frame. And while we were away, now Harry Sullins up on lane 24. While we were away, he took too much time in the previous frame to throw his ball, and that's an automatic $100 fine if you exceed 25 seconds. He's not aware of that yet, but he will be fined by the PBA. If he does it again, the fine is $1,000. Gets a little extreme after that first one.
Sullins with six strikes in the last seven frames. Possible 258 for Sullins.
Any kind of a mark at this point, a spare, will lock up the match for Harry Sullins. David Ozio's only hope is to strike out 224, and Sullins would have to open in the 10th frame to give him a chance. That's a winner.
Sullins is home free, and Ozio, a little disgusted at this point. He'll take $6,000 home, though, for his fifth-place finish.
Well, I'm sure what's going through Dave Ozio's mind at this point is the chance to be locked into that position for Bowler of the Year. With a win today, he, I feel, would have been Bowler of the Year with only two tournaments left on the fall tour.
I mentioned he led almost all week until yesterday when he slipped from the top spot.
And you can see the disappointment on his face there, but he'll be back next week, and he'll be tough again. One other major tournament left this year, Jay, and that's in Detroit, our last stop, the Players Tournament, the Touring Players Championship.
There's Ozio, of course. He was first from the second through the sixth round. Get an idea of... Stayrook made a big move late, as did Palombi. Oh, down the channel. Well, he was flirting with that, Earl.
That happens. You see that kind of thing happen. If anybody can make a small mistake, and where David is playing, right on the very edge of the lane, here's a good look at it. You get it to that very edge, and that one didn't hook back, just tilted off into the channel. Down the middle, just finish out. Give you an idea of how difficult the lane condition is this week. Del Ballard Jr., who will be the next player in on our telecast, had two games in the 130s this week, 135 and something like 137.
The 135, in fact, was in one game on the TV pair. It's 237 for Sullins, 204 for Ozio. Sullins against Ballard when we come back.
When you're the best, you can take a few knocks.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
With the best rust protection, Chevy Full Size is America's best-selling truck. Chevy trucks.
Like a rock.
The trucks you can depend on. The trucks that last.
I think they'll have shampoo there.
You might not have Head & Shoulders.
We're only going to be gone a week.
Right, a week. Head & Shoulders helps take care of the condition that causes flakes every day. Because you never know. You know?
Head & Shoulders. Because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
It's not easy to pull yourself away from a bowl on channel. Raisin Bran. A few scoops of raisin taste so good you'll find. But once you stop, you can't leave behind us. Two scoops taste too good to pull yourself away. Two scoops of raisin for the
hottest names in country music are about to take center stage, and the country will never be the same. It's the only place to see your favorite stars, because this ain't no video show. This is the real thing. Sunday, November 24th, the country's going to be hot on NBC.
Hi, I'm Linda Hamilton.
And I'm Mariah Carey. We'll be on Saturday Night Live this week.
Unless a killer cyborg appears from the future and prevents it.
Right.
Well, we take a look at the top 24 finishers in the action here this week at Lake Zurich.
Five lefties out of the top 24. One made the telecast. There's Billy Young and the old Gary Dickinson.
And Ricky Ward picking up $2,100. Charlie Tapp out of Kalamazoo with $2,300. One of our international stars, Eric Koch of Holland, won $2,400. Mike Dalby with $2,500. Boss Pencak cashing here.
As you can see, all these players, as we mentioned, are great shot makers. They are the kind of guys that keep the ball in play, and this is the highest finish of any of our foreign players, Jay.
Great star, Takeo Sakai of Japan. He is talented indeed. Rick Steele Smith and Mark Williams finishing sixth, winning $5,000. Well, we're getting set for match two as Harry Sullins has defeated Ozio 237 to 204 and meets Del Ballard. Del, who won this tournament in 1987 out of Richardson, Texas.
And Dell will be playing a different angle than the other players. He will be hooking the ball a lot more. Here's a good look at his style to the foul line.
And he came up just a little bit high. Ballard leaving the 3-6. We are joined by the commissioner-elect of the PBA, an old friend, Mike Connor from Akron, Ohio. And congratulations and good luck.
Thank you very much, Jay. I'm looking forward to it.
Got some challenges ahead, I'm sure, in these times, huh?
Well, that's true, but I think bowling has proved itself over the years to be very well attended. Over 70 million people bowl. The pros give it the interest to attract more people into the sport, and we're looking to help it grow in whatever way we can.
That is the voice of the new commissioner-elect as Sullen strikes on 24. Mike Connor. Mike, you, of course, were with the Firestone people many years ago when I first knew you, and you have a great background in sports marketing, promotion, product development. And the product of the PBA, of course, putting these great professional stars to the forefront of the public has grown very much under Joe Antonor and since the days when Eddie Elias got started, and we'll be starting a new era with you in January.
I guess that's right. As a sponsor for 27 years, our company has really been behind bowling. You see this talent that is on the tour today, we'd like to make it available for more young people coming into the game to be a professional.
Sullen's starting out in fine fashion, Earl.
He is, and he's really throwing the ball hard, and that's what's necessary to keep it in play. We've talked about that, and Del Ballard throwing the big hook, and on this lane condition, he gets a big break there, but on this lane condition, the more boards you cross or the more you try to hook the ball, the more trouble you generally can get into. And again, back to where we mentioned he's had 2 130 games this week, he's also had some very big games. So it gets on the right pair with the right ball reaction. He shoots the big game. If he doesn't, he can have that very small one. And looks, I think he should bowl well on this pair.
He's too. Very thrilled to get that like strike there.
Yes, I can see that.
You see, he defeated Sullins 215 to 204 in the match play this week. Coming up a little short.
And a very dejected Del Ballard walking back to the foul line. He doesn't seem to get the ball reaction he's looking for. He's going to have to make some adjustments. You can see him shaking his head. The adjustments he'll make, he'll go with more ball speed and go straighter to the pocket.
Mike Connor, in today's economy, I know it's tough, but certainly the sponsors who bring PBA action on television, on the networks and cable around the nation, they've hung in with you very well. People like Brunswick.
Brunswick has been a terrific sponsor for 20 years now at this event, but I think that's true, Jay. The people that are involved in the sport of bowling certainly realize that it does appeal to a wide audience. And I think the talent that's coming on the tour, some of the young professionals, they're more educated today than in the early years when Eddie and Joe got started. And I think that's one way we can continue to help the sport grow is to give them more visibility.
Well, the best of luck from all of us at NBC Sports to you and your staff and the PBA. Sullins is up by 20.
Thank you very much,
Jay. Good to see you, Mike.
Thank you, Earl.
Take care, Mike.
Sullins' career earnings of $364,000 plus. Four in a row for him. He has the lead over Ballard. More in a moment.
With a 2,510-pound payload, a 5,000-pound towing capacity, and a powerful V6 engine, the 1992 Toyota one-ton pickup might just surprise you.
If you could be the executive producer, would you choose to watch this great athlete? This one? This writer fulfill his dream? Or a team sport like basketball? Well, in the summer of 92, you can choose. Because in addition to NBC network coverage, there will be the Olympics triple cast. For the first time, you may choose from three different events on three separate cable channels for 15 days, 24 hours a day. Now you have the control to choose the event that you want to see. The Olympics Triple Cast. Call 1-800-OLYMPIC. A whole new way to see the games. For the first time in the history of the games, the Olympics Triple Cast lets you choose what you want to see, when you want to see it. For more information, call 1-800-OLYMPIC.
The Raiders. Nearly half the team is age 30 or older. Over the hill or an undying will? Just win, baby. The Al Davis way. Sunday on NFL Live.
Harry Sullins has opened this match with five strikes in a row. A 300 game means a 1992 ZR1 Corvette with that LT5 engine produced by Brunswick's Mercury Marine people. And the 10. And there goes his shot at the 300. I guess it jinxed him. The PBA also has a $10,000 bonus for a 300 game. At 16 300 games last year over at Northern Bowl, Glendale Heights. No 300 games here this week.
Highest game, I believe, of the tournament was Mike Albee's 299.
Correct. And there are the 300 games on television in the history of the PBA. The first one in 67, Bob Benoit in 88. Sullins in the driver's seat, up by 29. He's been having a lot of trouble at the approach, slipping, and he's been working on his shoes.
Well, these are the synthetic lanes, synthetic approaches, and what happens is you actually pick up static electricity. There's nothing dirty on the approach or anything like that. It's the static electricity will make the shoe stick.
Seven pin for Ballard. We did have that bug earlier, but we got rid of him.
Well, he just wanted a better seat than everybody else.
That's right. Ballard in his seventh championship round appearance of the year in June. He lost his only match to Danny Weissman at the Seattle Open. Top-seeded Kessler put together four consecutive strikes starting in the fourth frame to beat Mike Shady for his eighth title. Look at Dell here.
Here's a good look at the style of Dell Ballard. And one thing all these players have in common, remember, these are the best shot makers on the tour. Look how straight that arm swing is. Keeps it right down the line he wants the ball to take. Good full extension, good balance. All necessary ingredients to be a top player.
And Ballard leaving the two.
He's had a lot of trouble getting the ball to break properly. At the hook point, it seems to skid out on him. It's not making the turn he expects it to make. Del Ballard can get as much revolution on a bowling ball as anybody out here, and he's not happy with the back end he's getting.
Ballard, down by 31. Back with more action right after this.
I got suspended, Grandpa.
Brian, Keith, and Cloris Leachman will do anything to protect their grandson.
Please, you can't suspend him. Please, please, please.
Emily, Emily, don't humiliate yourself.
I don't mind.
From the producers of The Golden Girls and Empty Nest, the premiere of Walter and Emily tonight after The Golden Girls on NBC.
Me, the old Philly rock and roller. I like country music. I like it a lot.
Discover today's country music on FM 92.5 WXTU.
Starting Saturday at 9:30 a.m., the new Future Rest is going to offer you savings that'll knock you out of this world. Remember, that's Saturday only till 9:30 p.m. and only at the new Future Rest.
Before you choose a body shop to paint your car, ask a few questions. Do they use the best products to get the best results? What about experience? Have they painted more than 5 million cars? Do they know it takes more than paint to make your car look new? Will they take care of you as well as your car? Can they deliver this kind of work at a price you're willing to pay? If you don't know, you better get Maaco.
You haven't talked to your kids about drugs. Make an appointment.
Dad, you want to talk to me?
Find out who made the sexiest singles list Monday at 7:30.
NFL on NBC tomorrow. It all kicks off with NFL Live, Bob Costas and the crew, and then most of you will see the battle for the AFC West lead. Broncos traveling to Kansas City. Others will watch the Jets and the Patriots. Other regional action. Check your local listings. The NFL on NBC tomorrow. Harry Sullins in the lead. Sullins has left the 3-6. After a high hit, 6-7 in his career on TV, and he is open here in the eighth, and that'll chop into that big lead.
Coming down to the crucial frames here in this match, Jay, and Del Ballard, a very experienced player, he'll make his move now. If he's going to have any chance at all, he has to start striking here in the eighth frame. More direct, more speed.
Oh, boy.
That was the adjustment he had to make. He made the good move. He made a great shot. The lane he's had the most trouble on is lane 23, which he's up on next. This is a replay of that last shot. And watch how he goes more direct with the ball. In other words, straighter, more ball speed. But look at the revolutions, the power he gets on the release.
Ballard with that strike in the eighth. Earl's tip will be coming up a little later on, brought to you by the American Bowling Congress. Beyond the foul line, you're going to talk about league play. Ballard in the ninth on 23. Got it there. Ballard battling back. Has cut the lead to 9.
And how many times have we seen, it's time after time, when a player makes a mistake, the other professional will jump on that opportunity to get back in the match, and we have a dandy. 9 pins separating these two very tough players. Both have a lot of experience, Jay, in this situation. We could have an exciting finish. It could have a tie.
And it won't go down, the 2 pins there.
Harry Sullins seems to be having a problem with the approaches. Now, whether it's his shoe or something on the approach or what it could be, I don't know, Jay, but he seems to be having trouble getting through the shot.
I noticed him working on that shoe with a wire brush a few moments ago. Picks up the spare here in the ninth.
Well, no matter what Harry Sullins does in the 10th frame, he cannot shut out Del Ballard. Del Ballard with a possible 238. Harry Sullins, by striking out, could shoot 237.
Sullins, one of the iron men out here. He's bowled in 173 consecutive tournaments. Sam Flanagan holds the PBA record, 235 in a row.
That's amazing to me, how these players can maintain enough concentration week after week under this kind of pressure.
Strike on 23.
He got the important one, Jay. This one here, he must have to put the pressure on Del Ballard.
Sullins with a possible 237. Ballard, if he would go all the way, 238. And as Earl mentioned, we could have a tie. Uh-oh, disaster.
Well, not yet. It is. It's not what he wanted, obviously.
No.
That's. But what he done by getting that first, getting the mark in the 10th frame was the key. He'll shoot 226. Del Ballard will still need a strike. And here's a look at that last shot. He's still having a little problem with the approaches. He's not comfortable at the foul line. He's losing his balance.
So he was open in the eighth. Open here and a score of 226. Squarely up to Ballard, he can win it.
He needs a strike and nine.
And the 10 won't go down.
And the difference between when he struck on this lane in the eighth frame and now in the 10th, the difference, the angle of entry. The ball was a little wider going into the pocket. It came in behind the head pin slightly. The solid 10 pin.
Sullins is going to be our winner. Ballard could not get that strike, and now very dejectedly misses the spare, a score of 205. So Harry Sullins marches on, 226 to 205 over Del Ballard. And it'll be Sullins going up against Jess Stayrook when we return.
Brunswick Phantom. Bowling's first ball with a built-in guidance system, programmable to your game. Phantom's stealth core system works like onboard intelligence to give you unbelievable consistency and reaction predictability every time you strike. Get a Phantom. It's the guidance system for your game.
When what you eat and drink upsets your stomach, you want a medicine that works directly on your stomach itself. Pepto-Bismol. As it coats, Pepto delivers powerful medicine directly to your stomach, right where you hurt. It's powerful relief. Pepto-Bismol. It's real medicine for your stomach.
Betty White thinks she's running out of time.
Maybe 6 months.
Until one man gets her to take a second chance at a second romance.
I think we should spend more time together.
We're totally incompatible.
And takes her on the unforgettable journey of a lifetime. Betty White and Leslie Nielsen.
No, no!
In the feel-good movie of the year.
I've never dated anybody like you.
I'll never have another night like this.
See why TV Guide says cheers to Chance of a Lifetime. The world premiere of Chance of a Lifetime, NBC Monday.
Greg Norman, Lee Trevino, Hale Irwin, and more take to the beautiful shores of Maui, the Ping Kapalua International, today. Time now for Beyond the Foul Line with Earl Anthony, brought to you by the American Bowling Congress.
League bowling is great fun, but there are ways to make it more enjoyable. One of the big problems leagues are facing these days is slow play. As always, Mike Albee, American Bowling Congress roving ambassador, is with us. And Mike, in your opinion, what can be done?
Well, Earl, as you know, there's no magical solution, but there's one key. Every bowler should be all set to go when the previous player is finished. Your teammates shouldn't have to run over the bowling center and have you paged when it's your turn.
All right. It's kind of like baseball's on-deck circle.
That's exactly right. Bowlers need time to prepare for each shot. That's why you already should be up the ball return and ready to go when it's your turn.
Okay, that sounds like a great idea. What about the guy that gets up there, no problem, but it just takes forever to throw the ball? He just won't go.
I know as a sanctioned bowler, I always seemed to bowl my best when I did all my thinking before I got up on the approach. Once I got there, I went right away. Generally, the longer you wait, the more chance you had to tighten up. I don't know, you probably felt the same way probably when you bowled.
I agree, Mike. There's no way you can have all those things going through your head at one time and expect to throw a good shot. Do all your thinking before you step up on the approach. Another question I hear a lot is, how many lanes courtesy does a bowler need during league play, Mike? What do you think?
A lot of bowlers wait for too many lanes on either side of them to open up before they bowl. The American Bowling Congress suggests that you need only one lane on each side to open up before you start your approach. Just imagine how long it would take to bowl your lead if everybody waited two and three lanes to open up.
So being ready to bowl and following proper lane courtesy guidelines should help speed up play and make it more fun.
That's right, Earl. There's plenty of time to enjoy friendly conversation during your sanctioned league play, but when it's your turn to bowl, you should be ready to go.
Thanks, Mike. Now let's put that information to use, and the best place is by joining an organized league at your local bowling center. For more information on improving your league, contact the American Bowling Congress.
Harry Sullins defeating Del Ballard, 226-205. And now, Sullins will face Jess Stayrook, San Diego, California. The legend marching on here, Sullins' nickname. Sullins, after two matches, 7 of 12 strikes on lane 23, 7 out of 10 on 24. He's averaged 231. His opponents have averaged 204. He has done an excellent job to this point.
He has. He's bowled extremely well for a difficult lane condition. The scores are a lot higher than I expected, and as we get down to the top two spots left available, more money, more pressure, title coming up. This is a big championship, Jay.
We ought to mention $15 per every pin knocked down goes to the Omni Youth Services of Lake Zurich. As always, the Brunswick Corporation, Jack Reichert and all his people, wanting charity to be the big winner. Here's the prize list. Already we have had Ozio winning $6,000, Ballard gets $7,000, and third place worth $9,000, then $17,000, and $33,000 to the champion, and we're ready to go. Stayrook on the right, Sullins on the left. Match three of the stepladder finals of this Brunswick Memorial World Open.
Something that's kind of interesting here, and it's you don't see this very often. Even though the player higher in the standings has his choice of starting lanes, usually he'll want to finish first. In other words, he'll bowl his 10th frame first, and the way you do that is to start on the right-hand lane. Jess Stayrook, with the option, decided to start the match, which would give the opportunity for Harry Sullins to finish the match first.
Sullins, a high game this week of 257. Average 224.5 on the TV pair in two games. And the left-hander beginning on 23. 9 years on the PBA Tour for Jess Stayrook. Very athletic. He's got very strong arms and shoulders. Likes to play pool and golf when he's not bowling. His third championship round appearance of the year.
Jess is known as one of the guys that throws the big hook on the tour, and this is a very unique position he's in at the foul line. And he very seldom goes this straight with the ball. He's using a very shiny, smooth surface ball. He's trying to go almost straight down the lane and hook it on the back end. Normally, he would be standing 15 boards to the right of where he's standing and throwing it over the same arrow. Because the lane condition is so difficult, you have to go straight with good speed. He's made the adjustment, and he's really impressed me with his ability to do that.
Times have really changed on tour. Used to be you fellas go around with one or two balls. Now you got 15, 20, who knows how many they carry around.
That's right. And right back in the pocket where he left off, Harry Sullins, he's been really tough today with good ball speed. He's kept the ball in play all throughout both of his previous matches. He's going to be tough to beat. You know, something, as you mentioned, Jay, this is a state-of-art facility. Brunswick's
right.
Built here at Lake Zurich, Illinois, and it's a beautiful center, a beautiful facility. But one thing that we haven't mentioned that's very important, I think, is Brunswick being in the forefront of bringing out the wonderful innovations in the scoring units. And what they have here is called Bowler Track. And Bowler Track is something that is a wonderful teaching aid. If your local bowling center has automatic scores, they should definitely have Bowler Track because it can help the bowlers improve their game by showing them things like what board they rolled the ball over, where it is down the lane, what your ball speed was, how consistently you're releasing the ball. It's a wonderful thing. And we're going to show you how that works on Harry Sullins coming up here in the second frame.
Went back and worked on those shoes again there.
Yes, he did. And we'll get an idea of Harry Sullins' ball speed.
Looking good.
And we'll show you not only his ball speed, but where the ball went. As you can see it, it's tracked down the lane by the bowler track. And you see the ball speed at 20.8 miles an hour. He hit the 12 board at the 15-foot mark, 40 feet down the lane. It was on the 10th board at 55 feet. It was hooking back to the pocket and the 14-and-a-half board. It's a wonderful teaching aid. It's
really
something
is.
That can really improve your game. So, again, Brunswick at the forefront, bringing us the latest innovations in how to improve your ability in this sport.
And Jess Stayrook leaves a 3-6.
Here's a good look at Jess Stayrook on the split screen. This is a great way to look at a player. Remember, I was talking about how straight their arm swing are. But watch what he does. He steps off to the right to clear the ball past his hip. Very unusual. He gets the ball past his hip that way, but he creates tremendous leverage with his legs. That's where he gets that real heavy roll and hitting action that the ball has. And another reason is using a very shiny ball. Without that, if he used a dull ball, something that would hook more, he would have trouble keeping it in play. So Harry Sullins being very strong and throwing the ball very hard, Jess Stayrook of the same mold. Both players throw the ball very hard, and they're trying to keep the ball online to the pocket to eliminate any of the variances in the surface of the lane. Now here's an opportunity to watch Jess Stayrook on lane 23, and we'll see the bowler track on his particular style. He's a little confused. Remember, he came up light in the first frame on that lane, didn't quite get the ball back to the head pin. This one crosses over, and there again, you get a chance to see the actual pattern of the ball going down the lane, the ball speed at a little over 18 miles an hour. He hit the 7 board at 15 feet. It was up to the 8.5 board. As you can see, he is not bellying the ball. He's actually pointing the ball to the pocket at 55 feet. It was on the 16.5 board. The ball, once it left his hand, was always going toward the head pin and never went away. Now, if he could come back and sit down and look at that bowler track on the overhead scorer on bowler vision up there, Jay, he would say, well, no wonder I didn't get the ball in the pocket. I missed my target. So he could see that's what I mean by it being such a wonderful teaching aid.
Yes, it's part of their Brunswick bowler vision, which offers really a lot of interesting games you can play, but it's a marvelous teaching tool, the bowler track. Ten won't go for Harry Sullins. And he's still working around that release point, trying to get squared away. There he goes again with that brush on the shoes. Let's see. Might have got a little stuck there, Earl. I don't know.
Well, it's a stiff slick. You stick and then you slip is mm-hmm. what happens. Your heel hits the approach and it sticks, and then the forward momentum of your body goes through that position. You slip. And so you lose your balance, you lose your feel of the ball, and when that happens, you don't get the good revolution on the bowling ball, and you'll leave that weak 10 or the ring and 10, whatever it might be. You just don't get the same entry point. And Harry Sullins struggling with his balance and at the foul line, but still scoring extremely well because of the ball speed he's using.
Right on target there, a strike in the fourth. He has a slight lead, and we'll have more in a moment.
Stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million, felt like number one. Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me. Like a rock,
something to see. I go around.
The trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last.
I go around.
Chevy trucks. Grabbed the guitar.
Instead, she started rocking. No, I mean rocking.
You're pretty good.
Not.
Someone that hot deserves something this cold.
Bobby, I remember this as a bug spot.
I like your style.
Last year, they upset the favorite Runnin' Rebels en route to a national championship. Next Saturday, the Duke Blue Devils, led by All-American Christian Laettner, battle the USSR.
There's the Brunswick Memorial World Open, Wall of Champions. I mean, they've had everybody here. Andy Virapapa and Budweiser's. Earl Anthony, the honoree last year. And this year, of course, Milt Rudo and Eddie Elias. The Brunswick Memorial World Open, this special stop on the Far Fall Tour, and Jess Stayrook and Harry Sullins in a ding-dong battle here in match number three. Sullins and a split on 23, the 4-9.
This is a very unusual split for this lane condition. Very few of these were left this week. The 4-9, it means the ball is cutting through, it's driving too hard. The PBA is all the lanes, as I mentioned, 38 feet down and double oiled ahead, so it's hard to make the ball hit that well. And Harry Sullins, being one of the strongest players out here, can really make it hit, and he paid the full price there, Jay, for being just slightly high in the pocket with too much ball. He'll go cross lane at this and try to slide the four into the nine. And the ball didn't get anywhere near what he expected it to.
So Sullins is open in the sixth. Stayrook has taken the lead. Coming up next, except for those of you on the West Coast, a day of speed and horsepower. Sports World presenting the NHRA Winston Finals. And then following that, a little later, live coverage of the Ping Kapalua International Golf Tournament from Hawaii.
And as so often happens, when one of the players opens, the other jumps on the big opportunity to take the lead in the match. And Jess Stayrook, now in the driver's seat, whereas before he was completely lost, getting the strike in the sixth, a strike here in the seventh, would give him a commanding lead with only four frames to play. There's a couple of notable people that bowled and did not make the match play. Mark Roth, Hall of Famer, finished 29th, and Pete Weber back off to that six-month suspension. This was his first tournament back, barely missed the match play, finished in a tie for 25th.
10-pin is standing.
Very disappointed, Jess Stayrook, and for obvious reasons. A double there, as I mentioned, would have given him a substantial lead going into the last few frames of the match.
He hasn't hit the pocket very much in this match, but he's still in a great position to win it.
He is. Harry Sullins has been there every shot, got the bad break with the 4-9 and the 6th. It's just one of those things. I still feel Harry Sullins is the guy that has the edge in this match only because he's making better shots.
After this.
Coming, a night court so funded.
It's on Sunday.
It's not every day you get to see Dan Fielding nude.
Then, for the first time on television, Michael J. Fox.
Great Scott.
Christopher Lloyd. They saved the best trip for last. Back to the Future 3, following a special Sunday night court. All starting at 8, 7 Central, NBC Sunday.
We love our Philadelphia area, but road salt and chemicals eat our cars and trucks. Philadelphia is one of the most corrosive environments in the U.S. Don't let this happen to your car. Right now, get Zebart's Rust Protection Package for only $2.69. That's half off the regular price for Zebart Rust and Fire Protection with underbody sound barrier. Yes, you save 50% on our Rust Protection Package, regular $5.39. Now only $2.69. Come to Zebart Tidy Car. Save money and save your car.
With the highest resale value in its class and proven Honda reliability, the Accord truly is a safe place to put your money.
Elvis's Women Tell All About the King on Entertainment Tonight.
November 23rd, the Chevy Truck Classic will be in Rochester, New York, and then the Bud Light Touring Players Championship in Taylor, Michigan on November 30th. Those two events completing the 91 fall tour on the PBA and here on NBC Sports. Well, Jess Stayrook has now got a 22-pin lead. He struck in the eighth, and Sullins was open in the eighth. It's really turned around here, Errol.
It has, and still, Harry Sullins has hit the pocket eight consecutive times. He got the bad break in the sixth frame, leaving the 4-9, and then came right back here and left the 10-pin on the same lane and missed it. And Jess Stayrook, as so often happens, jumped on the mistake with a double. He's got a commanding lead. All he needs to do is stay clean in the 10th frame, and he's a winner. And there's the reaction on that second strike by Jess Stayrook.
And Sullins striking back on 24 in the 9th frame. Jim Bennett of Brunswick has asked me to remind bowling fans everywhere about the Salute to Champions 3 set up for St. Louis, February 22nd, 23rd at the Ritz-Carlton. You can contact the National Bowling Hall of Fame and Museum in St. Louis for further information about that wonderful weekend.
To have any chance at all here in this match, Jay, Harry Sullins must strike out in the 10th. He has a possible score of 195. Jess Stayrook going at a 207 pace. He could force Jess Stayrook to mark, and the match is over.
Yeah, Sullins has really lost it here.
He has, and it's more of an emotional thing. I think Harry Sullins having the first nine balls in the pocket, not getting a double, getting a bad break, and then missing the spare. I think it was a big emotional letdown for him, and he's just kind of given up at this point.
Well, he knocks down the 1-2-4. When he didn't pick up that strike a moment ago, look at Stayrook's reaction. Boy, he's got to feel lucky.
He does. He really bowled the type of game where he was lucky to stay out of trouble. He made a lot of bad shots. Not necessarily bad shots, but more feeling out the lane. He couldn't get the ball reaction he wanted. He's moved farther in on the lane. All week long, he's been playing between the first and second arrow, basically around the second arrow. Now he's playing between the second arrow, more ball speed, and going more directly to the pocket.
The left-hander is the winner. Congratulations from Harry Sullins.
All in all, not a bad day for Harry. He bowled three games, won two of them, moved up in the standings a little bit, and it was a nice payday for him.
Harry Sullins picking up $9,000 for the first prize, and of course, Stayrook will have a chance for the $33,000 top prize. Second place here pays $17,000. In this $200,000 Brunswick World Open.
And that boat from Brunswick. That's a nice additional prize.
It sure is. Nice hand for Sullins. He leaves the Bayliner 1700 Capri Bowrider. The boat, the motor, the trailer, the whole package from Brunswick. And a strike to end up on 24 and a score of 206 for Jess Stayrook. So it is Stayrook over Sullins, 206 to 175. Stayrook against Ron Palombi Jr. for the championship. Coming up.
I think they'll have shampoo there.
You might not have Head and Shoulders.
We're only going to be gone a week.
Right, a week. Head and Shoulders helps take care of the condition that causes flakes every day, because you never know. You know?
Head and Shoulders, because you never get a second chance to make a first impression.
I remember it well. I'd just come out of some of the most rugged country of Utah when I turned 200,000 miles on my truck.
I was way back in the woods. It's rugged. It's at the base of Chestnut Mountain. A lot of people won't go there, but it's a special place to me.
I pulled over the side of the road, showed a sign saying 200,000 miles. Is that cool or what?
Where were you when your Toyota truck hit 100, 200, or 300,000 miles? Call us and tell us your story.
The only truck I'll ever own will be a Toyota. I'll tell you that much right now.
This season, give the Olympics triple cast of the 92 Summer Games. Call 1-800-OLYMPIC, order the gold package, and get a set of Olympic pins, a commemorative book, the 92 highlights tape, and 2 solid weeks of all the best events. Order now and get a free Olympic warm-up jacket. Give the Olympics triple cast. Catch the fire behind the flame.
It's not easy to pull yourself away from a bowl of jam on Raisin Bran.
Sullins over Ozio, 237-204. Sullins moved on, defeating Del Ballard, 226-205. And then Jess Stayrook took the measure of Sullins, 206-175. We come to the uninterrupted championship match, Stayrook against the number one qualifier, Ron Palombi Jr. And Stayrook will begin it, $33,000 first prize. Bayliner Bowrider boat package. Of course, we've still got that Corvette for a 300 game, as well as a $10,000 bonus from the PBA for a 300 game.
This is the epitome of the new young breed on the PBA Tour. These guys are big, strong, can throw the ball extremely hard, and they can make it rev up.
Oh, he didn't like that. He's very animated today, very loose.
He's always been like that. He's a very likable young man. Jess is the kind of guy that you come up and talk to him, and he's very ebullient. He's just fun to be around. And he's got that, he carries that great attitude onto the lanes. You never see him get really nervous. He's got a lot of confidence in his game. Ron Palombi, on the other hand, is also very likable, but he's very quiet, reserved-type young man, and he won't be quite as demonstrative on the lanes as Jess Stayrook.
Jack Reichert, the president, chairman, and CEO of Brunswick, on hand today, a man who has meant so much to bowling, and he and his people continuing to support bowling in the Olympics, and their sponsors, of course, of Team USA, a man who really, truly loves this game.
He's done wonders for the game, Jay. He's been one of the innovators in a variety of things that have made the game grow around the world.
Ron Palombi Jr. opening with a strike. Palombi from Erie, Pennsylvania, 8 years on tour, and he's won over $500,000 in his career. Struggled this year a little bit. 20,890 so far.
Well, he's had some injuries, especially to his back. And what we'd like to do again is show you bowler track and use Ron Palombi, and we'll compare ball speeds, give you an idea of how hard he's throwing the ball. Remember, if you watch his game, he's very upright at the foul line. He likes to loft the ball well out in the lane, 7-8 feet before it touches the surface.
Oh, he got a break. It came up a little short. A lot of lift and loft with that.
He can overpower the surface. He's that strong. And again, as I said, the new young breed. These guys are great athletes. And here is a good look at Boulder Track. Ron Palombi's ball, 17 and a half miles an hour, but half of that's in the air, Jay. He hit the 17 board at 15 feet, let the ball go out to the 10 board, and at 55 feet it came back, was starting to hook back, and a very sharp break on the back end.
Well, that looked good, but he leaves the six. Cashed in 18 of 31 events this year. Very consistent. You mentioned the injuries for Ron Palombi that he's battled back from. Palombi in search of his sixth PBA title, and this young man, of course, last year came through with a tremendous win in the U.S. Open in Indianapolis. Stayrook in search of his third PBA national title.
No one has more confidence in their ability than Jess Stayrook. He's fun to talk to about the game. He's very knowledgeable about his own game. He really understands what he's trying to do on the lanes. He knows how to make the good moves on the lane. He's one of the better left-handers to come out on the tour in a long, long time, and he's got a bright future.
Well, that's high praise from perhaps the greatest left-hander of all time. I'm sure that most people would agree with me on that. And a strike on 23 for Stayrook. Coming up next, we've got Sports World with the NHRA Winston Finals, that most prestigious title on the line. Joe Amato seeking to become the first four-time winner, the top fuel champion, and then the Ping Kapalua International from out in Hawaii. Davis Love third leading that event. And look at the late 10 on 24 for Palombi.
Ron Palombi getting the big break. He starts the game with two very good shots. He gets the light hit on lane 23 for the double. Comes back in the third frame and showing you the power he has on the ball. Gets the pins dancing. The late hit, the pin coming across to kick the 10 out. That's the advantage of getting so much revolution on the bowling ball. It makes the pins dance and creates a lot of things happening on the pin deck.
Palombi has opened with three strikes. And he leaves the seven pin. I was telling you about those NHRA Winston Finals coming up in the Kapalua Golf. That is, except on the West Coast. You folks out there want to check your local listings. You'll be seeing that activity later today. Career championship record 16 and 12. TV, 213.41 average for Ron Palombi.
Now, Jess Stayrook, I mentioned late in the match when he was bowling against Harry Sullins, he made a move on the lanes, and it was a good move. He went from playing around the second arrow to between the second and third arrow. We're going to show you that on the bowler track, give you an idea of how he's changed his angle.
And the 10 goes down, and it's a strike for Stayrook.
And the power, he gets the rotation on the ball to drive that 5-pin into the 10. Now here's a look at it. The ball speed at 17.4 miles an hour. He hit the 12 board at the 15-foot mark, which is basically where the arrows are. The ball went out to the 9.5 board. At 55 feet, it came to the 12 board, and you can see the ball track on your screen as it moves back into the pin area. And here's the reaction of Jess Stayrook on that shot. You always know how Jess feels.
Yes, sir. Three in a row for Stayrook. If you're just joining us, you're watching the championship match of the $200,000 Brunswick Memorial World Open.
There's a replay of that last shot. Lots of ball speed, great rotation, and I can't emphasize too much how much wrist action, how hard they can get that ball to rotate.
Stayrook has been fined $100, going over the 25-second limit, so we've had a couple of penalties today, one earlier against Sullins, now one against Stayrook. Palombi leaving the nine pin.
And here's a good look at the style, the form of one of the great young players on the tour. Swings the ball behind his back, opens his shoulders, but squares it up at the point of release. And as you can see, he uses a lot of leg strength. Gets a good knee bend, good balance. Those things, as I mentioned earlier, very important for consistency in your game. Balance and use your legs. Get down over your knee with your shoulders.
As I mentioned, the former U.S. Open champion, boy, would he like to tack this title on.
And he's a very capable player. He's going to be around, as I mentioned, for a long time, Jay, because he's so talented, so young and strong, and he loves to play. He likes to practice. He works hard at his game. Unfortunately, the back injury that he's suffered with all throughout the year, there were times where he couldn't even tie his shoes. That's how much pain he was in.
I remember in 88 at Rochester when the Kodak folks sponsored the tournament there. He got a big victory. Pin. We'll be back in Rochester next week for the Chevy Truck Classic at Marcel's Olympic Bowl. Look forward to seeing all our friends
Marcel
there.
Marcel Fournier and, of course, Frank. Good old Frank.
Frank Formicola.
Looking forward to seeing those guys. Ron Palombi left the four pin on a great shot, almost had the 4-9, which was Harry Sullins' downfall earlier. And on the same lane. So that lane seems to be finishing a little harder in the pin area. Got a great match going here, Jay.
We really do. I want to congratulate Rick Barbera and his staff here at the Deer Park Lanes in Lake Zurich, this great new facility, for all of their help this week. They do a great job. Now Stayrook on 24.
Yes.
Stayrook up by a dozen.
I've mentioned how difficult the lane surface is. I'm amazed at how well these young guys can play on this surface. It's a wonderful surface, but it's just the pattern of the dressing on the surface that the PBA has put down to make it very competitive. And these guys are making it look easy, okay?
Five in a row for Jess, and is he happy?
Well, that could have been anything. It was a terrible shot, the worst shot he's made in two games.
High, wasn't it?
Right dead. Well, here's a look at it. A replay of that shot right through the middle of the head pin. This could have been the big four, a 4-6. Do you see the 4-7-10 standing? They go down, a little love tap on the four pin, and it's gone.
Watch the reaction here. Boy, is he pumped up.
He's praying. He's thinking, don't split, don't split. And then they went down.
Something bothering Palombi, and he is going to retool. Carol Dobbs is here, the head man of the American Bowling Congress, as we look at Stayrook.
And Eddie there Bauer, there's Daryl.
Yeah, there's Aaron.
He's done a lot of good things with the American Bowling Congress, and of course we've got Eddie Bauer, who is I've worked with a lot. He's done a lot of things for promote the Masters Tournament, one of the fine jewels in bowling.
Palombi got a bit of a break there on 24. He's left the seven.
Well, he would look at it the other way, Jay. He felt he should have struck on that ball.
Kick,
and we're talking about that tremendous rotation and power that he gets on the ball, and he's not very happy with that result. He thought it would be a strike. Easy spare. He'll go cross lane. Again, lots of ball speed. The players try not to hook the ball into the corner pins. They want to throw it hard and straight. They don't want the ball to overreact.
Through seven frames, Palombi is down by 23 to Jess Stayrook.
And it's just about now or never for Palombi, unless he thought all they can hope for is to get something going right now, because Stayrook on five in a row. You can't expect to get a break from Stayrook. He's too experienced. He will keep the ball in play. He's going to have to make his own breaks, Ron Palombi, by getting some strikes going right now. Eighth frame. In and watch him spin.
Well, this match, of course, means $33,000 to the winner, and that Bayliner 1700 Capri bow rider from Brunswick. It's a package of well over $65,000 when you total it all up. The 3-5-6-9.
Probably on the lane condition they're playing on right now, the most difficult spare he could leave, Jay. There's
a
multitude of ways
that.
To miss this and only a couple ways to pick it up. He has to guard against the ball hooking too much and chopping the 3 off the 5. At the same time, he has to hit it high enough for the ball to take out the 9.
Look easy.
That might have been whether he wins or loses this championship, picking up that spare, Jay. That's how important that shot was, because the pin count is almost even again by him only getting 6 on his first ball in the 8th frame. He's actually put Palombi back in the match. Here's another look at that spare. Now watch the ball, how close he comes to chopping the 3 off the 5. Just as it hits the pin, it barely gets the 5. Enough to do the job, though. 9th frame, chance to put the match out of reach with a strike here and maybe one in the 10th, and it'll be all over.
Stayrook, a possible 255. Well, it wouldn't go down the 10.
Well, right now, Ron Palombi is sitting on the bench saying, when Stayrook had the 5-bagger, he was probably thinking, what a dismal day this has turned into. Right now, he's still in the match, a chance to win it, possible 246 if he were to strike out the 9th and 10th.
And Stayrook now, a possible 244.
So it's anybody's match. A lot of money at stake. A big difference from first to second as far as prize money and everything.
The pressure building here. You'll see it in Palombi's eyes.
This is the one he wants, Jay. This one here in the 9th frame puts him in position to put the match away in the 10th. Without this one, he can only shoot 220, so he must have this strike. Keep him that 240 bracket ring. Gotta hurry.
And it didn't quite get up. Left the 4-8.
Now, he can't get too disappointed. The match is not over. He needs this spare. He's got to work hard. It's not an easy spare. Very difficult. Easy to pick the 4 off the 8. Got to pay attention. Concentrate. Pick up the spare. Get the double in the 10th. Make Stayrook mark. Possible 226 with 3 strikes in the 10th for Ron Palombi. Jess Stayrook going at a 234 pace. And finally, as you can see, the deep breath, the nerves are starting to show for Jess Stayrook. He knows he has the championship well in hand. He needs a mark to win. That's all he needs.
Palombi comes up short again, leaves a 5-pin.
And Jess Stayrook, just by keeping the ball on the lane, will be our winner. And here's another look at that shot. Earlier in the game, he was having the same problem. The ball wasn't hooking back quite enough. Then he got one a little too high, almost left the 4-9, if you remember. Gave it a little more room, didn't get it back. Difficult lane condition. Great shot makers.
Well, this will be the third national title for Jess Stayrook, and I can venture to say biggest moment of his bowling career.
And I'm sure his wife is thrilled. A wonderful lady, and Jess is a wonderful young man. He's going to win many more tournaments, Jay.
Is Mrs. Kathy? For Palombi. But Stayrook is only going to need six on his first ball to win the championship.
And he won't give this one a lot of room. He'll hit that head pin. You can count on it.
And that's the way to do it. Jess Stayrook of San Diego, California, is the 1991 Brunswick Memorial World Open champion here at this first tournament at the Deer Park Lanes in Lake Zurich, Illinois.
And there's the winning shot, Jay. He lined it to the pocket, didn't give it any room to leave that bucket again. Made sure.
Man, you're the man!
Congratulations from Ron Palombi. Look at him.
He was in contention all week to be one of the leaders, and he's demonstrated how tough he can be in the clutch.
It's Stayrook, 234. Palombi, 215. The champion, Stayrook. We'll meet him when we come back.
Look on target.
The Brunswick Phantom. Bowling's first ball with a built-in guidance system, programmable to your game. Phantom's stealth core system works like onboard intelligence to give you unbelievable consistency and reaction predictability every time you strike. Get a Phantom. It's the guidance system for your game.
Get into Bud Light. The clean, fresh taste won't fill you up, never let you down.
You
They named her Lucky Lady. But it'll take sweat, not luck, to get her flying again. And you need a deodorant you can depend on. Old Spice deodorant actually helps stop odor before it starts by killing odor-causing bacteria on contact, 99%. That's odor prevention you can count on with the clean scent of Old Spice.
Could I tear you away from your lady friend?
Old Spice deodorant. It does a number on odor-causing bacteria, 99%.
The speedway sizzles. The action gets hotter as the nation's top dragsters burn up the tracks in the final event of the year. The NHRA Winston Finals today.
Gail Gardner, welcome back to our Prudential Update studio in New York. In Frankfurt, Germany, the final stop of the ATP Tour World Championships. In the first semifinal, Yvonne Lendl, who had won this event five times, was beaten in straight sets by a recently rejuvenated Pete Sampras, 6-2, 6-3. The match took just 68 minutes. Today's other semifinal features Americans Andre Agassi against Jim Courier. The champion will take home a $1 million paycheck. And we'll be back with more right after this word from Prudential.
I couldn't raise the money to save the orphanage. I guess I'm a finny.
All you needed was some faith
and friends.
In the movies, happy endings are easy, but in the real world, they take solid planning. So for peace of mind, investment advice are the home of your dreams. Come to the companies of the Prudential and build your future on the rock.
Coming up after bowling, the Super Bowl of drag racing, the NHRA Winston Finals. Then we will send you to the beautiful island of Maui for final round coverage of the Kapalua International. Checking the present leaderboard with final round play just underway for the leaders. Davis Love III, who has been runner-up twice at Kapalua, is our leader. He has a four-shot lead over Mike Hulbert. Steve Tate and Jim Howitt are five shots back. Now, let's return to the Brunswick Open.
NBC Sports.
sports coverage of the PBA Fall Tour has been brought to you by Brunswick. Bowling is sold on Brunswick. By Chevy Trucks, the trucks you can depend on, the trucks that last. By Bud Light, everything else is just a light. And by Old Spice Deodorant, because prevention is the ultimate form of protection. Count on it.
Jess Stayrook is our champion. The victory over Ron Palombi Jr. And congratulations to the Blonde Bomber, as there is the Brunswick Memorial World Trophy. Fred Florjanic of the Bowling and Billiards Division to make the presentation.
Jess, on behalf of Brunswick, congratulations. It was a great match. Here's a crystal trophy signifying the winner of the Brunswick World Memorial Open.
Arnie Fogel, quickly the check, and we'll also mention, of course, that you're going to get a Dayliner bow rider boat. You want to say something as Arnie gives you the check?
I'd like to thank Brunswick, Fred, and Arnie, and Deer Park Lanes, and everybody that came out here. It was a great tournament. I hope we come back next year. Kind of like the lanes.
All right, congratulations. There he is, your champion, Jess Stayrook. This has been a presentation of Bud Sportsman Association.